We are now going to learn how to create a frequency table in APA style using Microsoft Word and Excel. These same steps will also work if you're using alternative word processing or spreadsheet software. Typically, you will use Microsoft Word for writing your research paper. And although Word does have tools for building tables, the secret to creating a proper table in Microsoft Word is to use Microsoft Excel. Here is our workflow. We will calculate basic frequencies in SPSS. We will export those frequencies in a Word format, but immediately copy them into Excel, where we will create and format the frequency table. Then we will bring the finished table back into our research paper in Word. I am using a fictitious data set, myclass.sav. These are scores on a math quiz for 112 students. I will be focusing on the variable quiz 4. The possible range of scores is 0 to 10 points. Our frequency table will include simple frequency, relative frequency, cumulative frequency, percentile, and sample size, which will go in the title. Go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Frequencies. You will notice that this option, Display Frequency Tables, is checked by default. This is what we want. If you uncheck Display Frequency Tables, a dialog box will pop up warning you that you have just turned off all output, so nothing will be calculated. If that happens, just click OK and recheck Display Frequency Tables. Move quiz 4, or quiz 4 score, into the variables box. Click on Format. Under Order, choose Descending Values. This will make our job easier later, because a proper frequency table organizes the frequencies in descending order. Now click Continue. We have just set our frequency tables to appear in descending order. However, and this is important, if any options are checked inside of charts, such as a histogram, then your frequency table will always be in ascending order. Not what we want. If that happens, fix it by clicking Reset and starting fresh using just the frequency table. But we have our example set up perfectly, so click OK. In the output window, we see the results. We have four columns, including frequency. The sample size is down here, 112. Because we have no missing cases, the percent and valid percent columns are exactly the same. Looks like everything that we need for our finished table, right? Not so fast. Actually, there is only one usable column of data here. Let's look at those column headings. We want simple frequency for our table, so we need this first column labeled frequency. We also want relative frequency, cumulative frequency, and percentile. But these columns are percent, valid percent, and cumulative percent. This is cumulative percent, not cumulative frequency. The only data that are useful to us are the descending list of scores and simple frequency. So only the first column will be useful to us. Also, and this is very important, not only are these not the data you are looking for, this table is not in APA style. You cannot submit a table like this for publication, and you cannot submit it in your homework either. This table is raw output. It's up to you to serve it up in a proper APA formatted table. There are a few other things wrong with this table. Now look at this list of quiz scores. Yes, they are in descending order, but what else do you see? Several missing categories. We are missing a 4 and a 1. So we have some work to do, but we can't do any of it until we get these numbers out of SPSS and into Excel. However, before we get to Excel, we need to export this output to Word. Click on this icon, Export. We will save this file to the desktop and call it Quiz 4. This will give us an RTF file that will allow us to cut and paste much more easily than exporting directly to Excel. I am going to open this RTF file in Microsoft Word and then save it as a Word document. I recommend that you do this whenever you run an analysis in SPSS. Export your findings to a Word document so that you can easily get to them even if you do not have SPSS loaded on the computer that you happen to be using later. Open the Quiz 4 Word document and then open a new Excel workbook. We are going to cut and paste from the first two columns in that table that we exported and move them into the Excel workbook. When I create tables, I like to give myself a little margin all around. So I'm going to paste these data into cell C3. Now we have extra columns and rows all around the table in case we need them. Because I only copied the columns that I needed, I will not need to delete the rest of the table. So now I can add column headings. Across the top row, type score and F for simple frequency. Simple frequency is the number of times that a score occurs, a count of the occurrences of every score in the data. The frequency table displays a column of data, X scores, and the number of times that that data point occurs. Scores are arranged in descending order of magnitude. And here's a formatting note. Use a lowercase f for frequency. Or, if you want this cool script F, type Option F on Mac or Alt F on PC. Back to our column headings, we need relative frequency, cumulative frequency, and percentile. Next, let's deal with these missing categories. We need a row for the score of 4. And we need a row for the score of 1. If you need more rows, highlight an entire row where you want the new row to go, right-click or control-click on the table, and choose Insert from the drop-down menu. We also need a row for the score of 1. The row is inserted above the row that you select. This same procedure works to insert columns if you need to. And you can delete unnecessary columns and rows this same way. Now that we have the rows for our missing categories, we need to add their frequencies. The fact that they were missing in SPSS means that they both had a frequency of 0. So now we have to calculate relative frequency, cumulative frequency, and percentiles. And here's where Excel really shines, because we can use the formulas to do the math for us. For instance, relative frequency is the proportion of times that a score occurs. Relative frequency is simple frequency divided by sample size. In cell E3, type the formula equal sign D3 divided by 112. Highlight the cell and double-click to copy it down the rest of the column. Cumulative frequency is the frequency of all the scores at and below a particular score. The cumulative frequency of a score is the frequency of that score plus the cumulative frequency of the score below it. To create this column, we need to start at the bottom. Type a 2 for the first cumulative frequency. Above that, in cell F12, type equal sign F13 plus D12. Now drag that formula up the column. The top cumulative frequency will be the same as the sample size, 112. And finally, percentile is the percent of all of the scores in the data that are at or below a certain score. It is the cumulative frequency divided by n times 100. Start with the numbers in the cumulative frequency column. Transform each cumulative frequency value to a percentile by dividing the cumulative frequency by n, 112, then multiplying by 100. In cell G3, type equal sign, open parentheses, F3 divided by 112, close parentheses, times 100. Double-click to copy that formula down and complete the column. Now that we have all of our data in place, we can do our APA formatting in Excel. First, let's clear any existing formatting and change the font. Select the entire table, and from the Borders tool, select No Border. To clear the shading, select the Fill Color tool and choose No Fill. Finally, the font for this table will be Times New Roman 12 point. Good. Now we need to add rules, or horizontal black lines, above and below the table. Highlight the top row of data along our five columns. Using the Borders tool, we will add a top rule and a bottom rule. Excel calls them borders. We will also add a bottom rule at the very bottom of the table. Rather than using the column spacing that Excel gives us, let's select the entire range of columns and adjust them slightly. They can be a little narrower. I like to keep all of the columns the same width when I can. Next, we should center the titles in the header. And we should center the scores in the first row. Right justify all scores in the other cells. This will help the decimal points line up correctly. And speaking of decimals, we can adjust the display of decimals with these icons to add or to remove decimal points as needed. Select these three columns and use the Decrease Decimal tool to make them all two decimal places. Of course, cumulative frequency does not need decimals, so we can select only that column and set the decimals to zero. Okay, now we are done with the APA formatting. Time to get this table into Microsoft Word and finish it. Select the entire table. Copy. And now, flip back to your Word research paper document. Paste the formatted table here. Now we need to title the table. Each table must have a number and a title. The numbers run sequentially. Your first table is Table 1, so we will call this Table 1. Your second is Table 2, and so on. On the next line, add the title. Type Frequencies of Scores for Quiz 4. This is a good place to add the sample size as well. Type comma, open parentheses, capital N equals 112, close parentheses. Titles are in title case and italicized. And there is our properly formatted APA-style frequency table.